Now, I want you to put your hand down if you have a physical or learning disability. Put your hand down if you're part of the LGBTQ community. Put your hand down if you could be discriminated against because of your religious preference. Put your hand down if you were a woman or gender non-conforming. Put your hand down if you identify any part of you as a race other than Caucasian. Put your hand down if you love anyone who would have put their hand down for any of these things. Now I want you to open your eyes and look around. There is not one person in here who would not be affected by conversion therapy laws. When any group is affected by a loss of human rights violation, every other minority group is affected. America preaches time and time again about life, liberty and the pursuit of happiness, and liberty and justice for all. This has been tried in court innumerable times. Laws have been passed against this, against discriminating people on the basis of the gender and race and disability and everything like that. We even had a war about it in 1861 as America fought to try to decide what it meant to be free. Conversion therapy violates basic rights to safety and can permanently damage children that go through it. Society has a social responsibility to make this country safe for all the people in it. As a democracy, the way we change laws is through voting. Everyone is socially responsible for the decisions while voting to make these illegal. Conversion therapy on minors can be emotionally and physically damaging. We need to implement a national ban to make conversion therapy illegal for people under 18 who cannot make these decisions for themselves. I'm wearing this awesome shirt today to remind everyone that this is not a right that everyone enjoys in our country. Conversion therapy as a whole threatens our individual freedoms in a society that was built upon those who fled to be providing a safe place to bring up their families. Conversion therapy is a pseudoscientific practice of trying to change an individual's sexual or gender preference using physiological or physical interventions. People in the United States pay professionals to alter their child's mentality regarding homosexual or genderqueer ideas. The American Medical Association states that there is no proven constant evidence that conversion therapy of any sort can change an individual's mind. That means it doesn't work. According to the Washington Post, almost 700,000 children in the United States have gone through conversion therapy of some sort. That's the entire city of Seattle right now. Now, there are a few laws in place that can make conversion therapy illegal in some places. Six states have half laws in some country or in some counties, and 14 states have statewide bans. But this means that 30 states, the ones shown in tan here, have no laws whatsoever against physically abusing children to change their sexuality. People have general freedoms at 18 years old, but until then, their parents completely run their life. While parenting in its various forms are controversial subjects, basic rights of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness are infringed when a child is sent into conversion therapy. Typically, the therapy includes associating pain or uncomfortable mental states with these genderqueer ideas, thoughts, or behavior. Risks of the practices include depression, guilt, shame, social withdrawal, suicide, substance abuse, problems with intimacy, and a feeling of being dehumanized, just to name a few. The methods, risk factors, age complications, and such make it blatantly obvious that subjecting your child into conversion therapy is a form of child abuse. A dangerous and ineffective way to change the sexuality of youth in our country, conversion therapy is still legal in the majority of our country. We as individual people can't change each state one by one. However, we can do our part to change the country as a whole. What we need is a national law that forbids conversion therapy to hold state accountable for abolishing conversion therapy. According to lawhelp.org, matters of discrimination regarding race, sexual orientation, gender, religion, or disability fall under the national responsibility, not states. This particular subject typically requires that you vote for people who believe in LGBTQ rights. But this is not just a matter of whether or not you support these rights. This is about child treatment. We need a national law that forbids conversion therapy, and the way we get that is to vote responsibly. We need to vote for supporting candidates and vote to pass these bills into laws. Without a national ban at the current pace, our children will undergo, or 20,000 children will undergo conversion therapy in the next few years. According to the Child Mind Institute Journal, LGBTQ youth are already one of the most at-risk groups for suicide, and conversion therapy only increases those numbers. If we were to pass a national law, this would bring those numbers down to virtually zero for that community. With the passing of one law, we can increase awareness for the equality as well as drastically decreasing the number of teens affected. If we do this, we can gradually start shaping our country into the place of peace and safety we want it to be. Conversion therapy makes children being subjected to being physically and emotionally altered by a psychological professional. It's been proven ineffective, and the majority of states still allow it. A federal ban would protect the minors in the community from being subjected to unfair treatment. Passing this law would decrease the number of teens traumatized post-therapy. And voting is a right that we all enjoy because we live in a country that supports these unalienable rights. Typically, things gravitate towards the masses, and each minority group that is underrepresented gives more power to the majority. When I asked you earlier to put your hands down as I listed the top five minority groups, almost everyone had their hands down. And when I asked you if you loved someone in any of these groups, every single hand in this room went down. So when I say this affects everyone, I really mean this affects literally everyone. We need to fight to protect the minorities, and I don't know about you, but I want to be proud when I think of our country and know that we are a safe place for all people.